could just do it.
Right.
You know, he could just make it happen. So my thing is that I see so many people out here that feels that I don't have an education, I don't have a diploma, I don't have any degrees. I'm just gonna give up. I'm tired of a person. I can't succeed. Nobody wanna give me a job. But it all comes back to ownership. You have to own what belongs to you. You only can create your beauty in a happy place if that's where you want to be.
And that person too, because like me, I do have, you know, I've been to college, but I'm more of a hustler. So if you think that you're a hustler or nature, you're going to achieve whatever you kind of put your mind to when you want to open a business. Because you're a hustler, you're going to research. Hustlers research what they do.
Hustler don't get out there and hustle.
Whether you have education or you're going to research.
You're going to hustle.
I have a brother that has his second PhD, and it's still he's not a hustler like me, but he's very educated, book-wise. And but it's still kind of hard for him to kind of get in that groove, even though he has the book education.
Yeah, but he can't beat your hustle, you know what I mean? He can't beat your hustle.
You know, it's just like you said, everybody goes back to your ownership. You have to own what you want. You have to believe in you,
and I believe that.
And there's nothing wrong with education. Education is good. I mean, I'm just starting to see a lot of people that are educating or graduating from college and doing this and doing that. It's just hard for them to actually put themselves in that position, what they want. Like, they have so many hopes and dreams. I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. And then you get out and you have this degree, but now where are the jobs?
No,
that goes back to what I said with our community. You know, who are the jobs for? You don't have a job, and then you give them a job, you can't live off this. You know, so you go to school for 4 years or 8 years to get out and to make nothing compared to what this hustler like me sitting here making.
Right.
You know, it's crazy though.
And but you know what it's like, what we do,
we're driven,
you know.
Yeah,
we're
driven.
Right. Yeah.
Myself.
Yeah, you know, and Todd, you know, it's like, I know I'm a hustler, I'm a grind. My mother can tell me, you should have been made. No, she used to say, you gonna make it. Yeah. You know what? I'm making it. Mm-hmm. I'm making it. And you know what? If I'm looking back over my life where I came from, ladies, if I ever would have known that I would be where I am tonight, I wouldn't even believe it. And Anita looking at me because she smiling down on me. It's like, boy, from where God can bring you from until where you're at now.
That's right. And I think that is the key.
Yes.
As I'm listening to Tara, and what she's saying is so true that you can be an inspiration for people who are on the verge of a dream.
Yes. Right. Yes.
And offering that information, offering those resources. I think that's a powerful place of sisterhood, right?
Yes.
And when we connect, or at least when I connect with that power behind me, which is God,
amen.
Then that's when everything happens. Whether I have a 20 PhDs, or whether I have
$1 million,
no education,
right,
whatever.
If God ain't in your circle, it ain't happening.
It's not happening.
Right. It ain't happening.
And I think we have to say yes when we hear the call. Because we hear the call, everybody hears the call, but sometimes we don't say yes.
Yeah.
Like, you should do this. This is a great idea.
Have your way, Lord.